got something to hide. I think she wants a clown, someone to take for a ride. But this is what I say, I'm too experienced to be taken for a stroll, too experienced for someone to rock and roll. I'm too experienced to be taken for a ride, and I know it's not my foolish pride.
Thank you. Like as wine.
Marijuana.
What? Well, we're live.
That is hilarious. Wow.
Oh, well, you guys like wine wise. Marijuana.
Pretty much.
That's a new
so,
one?
Wait, what other wines? I like sweet ones.
So get into
it. I'm just getting into it, that's why.
So you just
the dry wines I can't.
I don't like dry wine.
Because yeah. I'm just getting into it, that's why.
What made you start drinking wine? Well, y'all know we live, so if y'all want to say what's up.
Oh, well, maybe, well, I don't know. What made me get into wine? It was just like a cheap alternative to like weed and liquor. You feel what I'm saying? If you buy Henny, you spend $40.
Where? In what country?
I mean, I live in New York. So if you go in and get some Henny, you know what I'm saying? You got to think about Henny. In a long way, in a week's way, not just like copping a little purse.
Are you drink that much?
Nah, you gotta think about it. Think about it. If you working, having a hard day, you might just want to drink. Mm-hmm. If you cop the person and you finish a person in one day, it's better to cop
in a
big bottle and have it there than let's say you know. Wednesday, you might have a long day. You drink.
Mm-hmm.
You might not have a long day until next Tuesday, but at least you have something there instead of going to the supermarket and buying another $18 personal or $12 personal Hennessy instead of having the bulk of it.
You want to hear something really weird? So, like, I've been an athlete most of my life.
Same.
You know what? I've been so conditioned not to, like, I love to drink. Now, don't get me wrong.
Mm-hmm.
But I think, you know what my tension release thing is? Is like, I find a movie I haven't watched in a long time, and I watch that.
Okay.
And that's how I relieve stress. Okay. So I just, like, I don't be bothered. Like, I don't talk to anybody. I don't, you know, I watch a movie, catch up, and chill. And I only drink, because I can't drink at home, because if I drink at home, I feel like an alcoholic. I feel like I have a problem. So when I'm out, I drink.
That makes sense.
It's weird, right? But it's just like...
You're a social drinker.
Me, my thing is...
Somewhat, yeah.
I have so many different ways of releasing stress. I like to smoke weed.
Masturbate.
You can masturbate. We can,
I did invite you.
We can drink liquor. Working out.
Mm-hmm.
Even catching a movie, that is a good idea.
Mm-hmm.
Like, low-key, even thinking about it now. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Watching a movie that you haven't seen in a long time can release a lot of stress. But so it's a lot of different ways that I release stress. It's not just all one way. So that's why, when I'm drunk, I like to think of myself like this. I like to laugh at myself.
Really?
Yeah, I like to laugh at myself. I'm a person that likes to laugh at myself. So it's like... I think I'm like the best comedian, so I laugh at my jokes all the time. People find that corny, but I laugh at my jokes all the time.
That's real.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? It's just having fun with yourself, having fun with life. It's like, if you look around yourself, everybody's miserable, really.
Man, that's real.
About something.
You know what's deep? If you ever go to a club or an event like that, and you're the only one sober... Mm-hmm. And you watch other people. It's like the most awkwardest thing ever.
Really,
you be like, what are they really turning up to? Because like, hey, this is, I heard this shit on the way here. And I know That's wild. Like, that's really weird. I just thought it was me.
But it's just you spending, you basically spending like $300 more to right, really do the same shit you've been doing in the car when you was doing in the house.
I thought it was me.
No.
So look, man, everybody's here. Are you gonna, Ashley, are you gonna participate this evening?
She said no.
You got a bonnet on. You got to participate.
Yo, really, you're really.
They're
looking for outside.
Extra, man. So let's go around the room.
Disgusting.
Everybody introduce yourself. So they're once a visitor, they're no longer visitors. You all are part of the show. So
appreciate
we're gonna start to my right and introduce yourself. If you like. To my right. This is my right.
Oh,
okay, geez. We'll do Shapes and Colors next week. Everybody's favorite to hear you wear. Anyone introduce yourself?
What's going on? My name is Keon, a.k.a. Keezus.
Keezus? Keezus?
Keezus.
That's your name?
No.
All right. That's is that your, that's like, Snapchat. A.k.a.
Snapchat. That's my alias.
All right. Why did that, why you came up with that?
I don't know. It wasn't me. Somebody gave it to me.
You ran with it. You like
Jesus.
Yeah.
To 12 o'clock in front of me. You want to introduce yourself to the world?
Miss Bad and Bougie.
Shut up. It's Alicia.
With the coolest last name in the world. Tell me your last name, Alicia.
Coke.
Yeah.
Oh, Coke. Mickey Monday.
Coke.
Cocaine Cowgirl.
You can't, have, like, you can't have a cooler last name than that.
C-O-K-E.
You ain't lying.
C-O-K-E, yeah.
Coke.
Damn. Are you are you on a run from the law? You got a government appointed name?
No, the funny is it's just it's weird because like my dad's Cuban too, and the fact that his last name is Coke is just
automatically a criminal.
It's a stereotype.
Automatically, cocaine cowboy, no question.
Pass those fried chickens.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So I wish y'all really could see that we got a pot full of fried chicken.
Yes.
Like it's a, like it's a, like it's popcorn.
And we please understand I'm not from here, so this is
napkins going away around. All right.
And we got Noel and Steven on this side as
hold
well.
Hold on.
Noel and Steven. Go ahead, because he's preparing himself for chicken. We just
Noel again. Participating.
Alright guys, she did tell me to watch this chicken, so what I'm
going
to do is I'm
going to
remove it.
So that
way
it doesn't work.
Go to
bullshit.
Another chicken on the grill.
Yeah, it's more than one chicken. Oh, don't let the fan fall, genius. Alright, Steven, doing. You want to introduce yourself? Well, I just did, but go ahead.
Steven, eating green fried chicken right now.
Mm-hmm, real black of us tonight.
Mm-hmm, really.
Really, so y'all tuned in, what's man. We had some great feedback from the last show.
Did we?
Mm-hmm. And even though we started late, I guess most people are accustomed to me starting late.
Okay.
So it kind of worked out. And so our newest member, who Keezus.
Yay.
And
Shy City.
He came through and he actually called in. And on the, what's the, did you call in on Tuesday? What the hell? Well, Thursday. Damn, my days are running up. You called in on what subject about? You remember? You want to say that for later?
Let's say that for later.
Okay, we'll say that for later. Right now, you Keezus.
Keezus.
Okay. And, but we had some great feedback, man. A lot of people really enjoy the conversation, the dialogue that we have. This is so niggerish of us.
I need to say
chicken. This is so...
I wanted to try to ignore that.
I can't ignore us just sitting up and eating chicken like...
We got any negative feedback?
No. No negative feedback. Mm-mm. Most people expect the show to be what it is, and it works out. So tonight, what I'm gonna do right is go over some topics and some news that I didn't go over with, and then we'll talk about that too. We'll converse about that too, y'all. So on this was. This hat. Oh yeah. So, speaking of people that have marijuana habits, y'all know Damian Marley.